Hello everyone, welcome back with another interesting video lecture on veterinary and medical entomology. In this lecture, I'm gonna discuss hypodermia species or warble fly infestation or hypodermiasis. First, I will highlight the morphological features, important species, and life cycle of hypodermia species or warble flies. Then, I will discuss the veterinary and medical significance, diagnosis, treatment and control of hypodermia species or warble fly infestation or hypodermiasis. Follow my channel's playlist to get more video lecture on veterinary parasitology. Stay connected with this channel to get more video lectures on different subjects of veterinary medicine. So, let's get started. This is the classification of different flies. You know, we studied different important veterinary arthropods under the suborder Nematocera, Brachycera, and Cyclohepa. You can see different important families under the suborder Cyclohepa. Flies under the Estridae family are commonly known as nasal bird fly, or warble fly, or stomach bird fly, or skin bird fly. They are moderately large, bee-like flies with vestigial or primitive, non-functional mouth parts. Due to the rudimentary mouth parts of these adult flies, they can't feed, rather imbibe the fluid only. These flies have small eyes located in large interocular space. Larvae of these flies are stout, thick, and obligatory ectoparasite of different mammals, known as grubs. There are four important subfamilies under the family Estridae. They are Estrini, Hypodermatini, Gasterophilini, Cuterbrini. Follow my other lectures on nasal bird fly, stomach bird fly, and New World skin bird fly. In this lecture, I will discuss hypoderma or warble fly or Old World skin bird fly. There are 9 genera, 31 species occurring in cattle, deer, goats, and rodents under the subfamily Hypodermatini. The most widespread and important genus under this subfamily is Hypoderma. Hypoderma bovis and Hypoderma lineatum are important parasites of cattle. Hypoderma bovis is known as northern cattle grub due to its distribution. Hypoderma lineatum is considered as the common cattle grub. This fly is also known as hill fly due to the defensive behavior of cattle in kicking up and down their hoofs to get rid of this fly attack. The larval stages of Hypoderma bovis and Hypoderma lineatum is known as ox warble. These flies are mostly distributed in many countries of the northern hemisphere. Both species are considered major economic pest of domestic cattle. Some other species of Hypoderma that cause cutaneous miasis in different animals are listed here, and their distribution is Arctic and Holarctic region of the world. Disease caused by Hypoderma species, particularly by their larval stages, is called hypodermiasis or warble fly infestation or infection. Morphological features of Hypoderma species or warble flies. The adult Hypoderma species are V-like hairy flies around 1.3 to 1.5 cm in length. The anterior part of the thorax is greenish yellow in Hypoderma bovis and yellowish white in Hypoderma lineatum. The abdomen is covered with light yellow hairs anteriorly, followed by a band of dark hairs. The posterior portion bears orange yellow hairs. Other characteristic features include a well developed postscutellum and squamy, which is similar to the features of nasal bird fly. The apical cell of the wing of Hypoderma is open, that is, bearing four meets the wing margin independently of wing vein 3. The larvae are whitish, become dark brown in color over time, and pupa become black. The full-grown mature larva is somewhat barrel-shaped, tapering anteriorly around 2.5 to 3 cm in length. The mouth hooks of the larval stages are rudimentary, which is different to the larval stages of the genera Estrus, Gasterophilus, and Dermatobia. The posterior spiracle are large with many small openings, which is similar to the nasal botfly, but different to stomach botfly and New World skin botfly. Just note this piece of information, the differential points among the features of the different subfamilies under the Estrini family. Life cycle of Hypoderma bovis and Hypoderma lineatum or warbler flies. Flies are active in warm condition, particularly between the month of late spring to early summer. The female of both Hypoderma bovis and Hypoderma lineatum lay eggs while in flight or walking over the host. Female flies deposit eggs more commonly on the legs or lower part of the body of the host. Hypoderma bovis lays its eggs singly, while Hypoderma lineatum deposits a row of 6 or more eggs on a single hair. Eggs usually hatch within 3 to 7 days. Then, the first instar larva crawl down the hair, penetrate the skin, and migrate to different parts of the body. It is noted that the migration of the larva is aided by the mouth hooks and proteolytic enzymes secreted from the midgut. The exact route taken by the migrating larvae in the host is not well known, but the L1 can be found in various sites of the host body, even in the internal organs. So during winter, the migrating larvae are found in epidural fat along the spinal column in case of Hypoderma bovis. In case of Hypoderma lineatum, they are found in the submucosal layer of the wall of the esophagus. With the onset of spring, that is after 4 to 6 months of migration, these larvae of both species leave the resting sites and move to the host back around 2.5 cm either side of the midline from shoulder to tail. In this location, larval instar 1 moves to larval instar 2. The larva cuts a hole in the skin called warble pore, through which it respires and develops to larval instar 3. A boil-like warble develops around the enlarging maggot, that is around L3 larval stages. The larval instar 3 then forces its way through the breathing hole in the skin and drops to the ground. This stage is vulnerable to predation by birds, rodents, and other insectivores. Therefore, it seeks cover on the ground and burrow soil to pupate. Adult flies emerges within 1 to 3 months, which seeks partner to mate again to lay eggs. Veterinary and medical importance of hypodermiasis or Hypoderma or warble fly. First, I will discuss the veterinary importance of Hypoderma or warble fly. The damage is caused by adult flies and their larval stages. When adult flies approach an animal to lay eggs, animals become disturbed and run with their tails high in the air to get rid of this attack. Animals may damage themselves on fences or wires, or may be killed by getting into water or falling over the hides. Due to fly annoyance, the grazing time of the animal is reduced. This results in a reduction of weight gain and milk yield, resulting in production loss in terms of meat production and milk production. In 1978, the loss was 3 million pounds due to losses of animal by gadding. Damage caused by the larvae of Hypoderma species in several ways. Due to passage of larvae in the muscle creates jelly-like tracts, which is called lick beef. It results downgrading of meat. Further, if larval stages die in different tissues or organs, particularly near the spinal canal, causes a severe reaction to toxin released from the dead larva, which leads to the death of the animal due to anaphylactic shock. Dead larva in the spinal canal may also lead to paraplasia. Death of the larvae, particularly hypodermal lineatum in the submucosal connective tissue of the esophagus, cause inflammation of the esophageal wall, which is clinically manifested by dysphagia, drooling, and bloat. Downgrading of heights also results from larval and breathing holes on the skin by the larval stages. Please note that a granulomatous reaction surrounded by the larvae where L2 molds to L3 is called larval. A breathing hole ranging in size from a small slit to a round hole of 3 to 4 mm in diameter is also recorded. Downgrading of heights is associated with huge economic loss. In 1982, loss of £35 million in Great Britain was reported. Moreover, breathing holes also lead to secondary bacterial infection followed by abscess formation, which may even lead to death of the animals. Hypoderma species may invade unnatural host as well. A study reported that invasion of brain of a horse by Hypoderma bovis may kill it. The medical importance of Hypoderma or larval fly infestation is very less. In rare cases, humans who are closely associated with cattle may be infected with Hypoderma species. Infected humans may suffer from creeping miasis due to wandering of first instar larva and abscess formation. Occasionally, eyes may be invaded by the larval stages and be destroyed. Diagnosis of hypodermiasis is based on the increased fly activities during summer season and the presence of eggs on the hair. The presence of larval on the back of the cattle confirmed the cases of hypodermiasis or larval fly infestation. Treatment of hypodermiasis includes early and late treatment. Prophylactic treatment is directed against the larval instar 1 before they arrive at the resting site to avoid economic losses. Before that, a spraying of the insecticide can also be practiced to kill the eggs on the body of the host. Therapeutic or late treatment is directed against larval having the larval instar 2 and 3 to interrupt the life cycle of Hypoderma species. Systemic insecticide with different macrocyclic lactones such as duramectin, ivermectin, or moxidectin can be used as pour-on or injectable forms for the treatment, control, and prevention of Hypoderma species, and also for other miasis-causing flies. Single annual treatment is recommended for the control of Hypoderma species before the larvae appear on the back of the animals. In case of pour-on application of this compound, the skin or hair coat must be dry. It should not be applied on a wet body coat or when rain is expected to wet the cattle within 6 hours of application. Moreover, the application site or body coat should be free of skin lesion, mud, or feces. Mechanical or manual extraction, that is by squeezing the individual larva, is contraindicated. Larva can be removed by careful injection of 1 ml of 3% hydrogen peroxide with a blunt cannula. Care must be taken not to rupture or pierce the larva during removal. If larvae are crushed or pierced, it leads to a severe immune reaction leading to death of the individual due to anaphylactic type reaction. You know, this reaction occurs from the overwhelming and sudden release of Hypoderma species antigen. This type of reaction can also be observed during treatment when the larval stages reach to the spinal canal or esophagus. Therefore, early single annual treatment is good, but not later than 8 to 12 weeks before the anticipated first appearance of growths on the back. However, untreated animal remain a reservoir of the disease, causing rapid reinfection in the hearse. Where systemic insecticide cannot be used, hypodermic species larvae can be controlled by the application of tetrachloroethylene phosphate dust. It should be applied to the larval on the back of the animal. This treatment must be repeated every 30 to 40 days during the larval season to kill the new grubs that continue to appear on the back of the animals. Overall, the control program is very difficult. A specially designed eradicated program should be recommended to reduce the prevalence of hypodermic species in an area. Thank you for watching this video. If you have questions, write them in the comment section below. I'll be happy to answer. Stay well and best luck for your studies. I'll see you in the next lesson.